Zinc gutters drain rainwater and in the process develop a natural resistance to corrosion. When zinc is exposed to wet and dry cycles, a chemical reaction occurs, forming a protective patina on its surface. No paint or special treatment needed. You can't stop the rain, but you can stop it from damaging buildings and their foundations. These U-shaped zinc gutters funnel water away from the structures to keep them dry. The process starts with the production of these 46-ton coils of zinc. The zinc arrives at the factory in the form of thick plates. These plates are almost 100% zinc. The plates drop into a furnace. Inside, the temperature reaches 750 degrees Fahrenheit. Workers add a bit of copper and titanium to reinforce the zinc, and it melts into a homogeneous liquid. The molten zinc then flows into a trough-style conveyor system. Residues like ashes float to the top of the metal soup, and a worker skims them off. A floating puck monitors the speed and depth of the zinc blend to prevent overflow. The molten zinc now arrives at the casting machine. Here, 3-foot-wide steel unwinds, and once linear, the zinc flows onto it. The steel acts as a mold to form the zinc into a long, rigid sheet. Water flows onto the zinc to accelerate cooling and solidification. Since water and liquid zinc don't mix, the water simply runs off the surface. Now solid, the zinc plate is almost a third of an inch thick, far too thick for making lightweight rain gutters. The next operation will thin the plate down dramatically. This is a powerful rolling mill. The pressure on its rollers is so great that they often must be replaced. Once the new rollers have been loaded, the mill heats them up. The operator activates the rollers. As they revolve, the hot rollers exert 770 tons of pressure to iron the zinc much thinner. Meanwhile, just ahead, a steel bell tensioning system swings into action. This system prevents slackening in the zinc sheet as it exits the rolling mill and moves forward. You can see the difference the rolling has made. It has reduced the thickness of the zinc sheet to about 3/4 of a millimeter. The steel belt system maintains the tension in the zinc sheet as it's wound around a core. This produces the 46-ton coil of zinc. It's known as the mother coil. Approximately 25 miles of rain gutters can be made from this coil. Workers slit the mother coil into three. Each coil is 1 foot wide. It is now the correct width to be formed into rain gutters. A crane lifts one of the narrower coils over the factory floor. Its journey is guided by the operator below. This puts it in position to be mounted to the next machine, one that will cut it into uniform 13-foot-long strips. That's the standard length for the rain gutters. As the zinc uncoils, an overhead mirror provides a top view for the operator. In quick swoops, the blade slices the zinc sheeting to the correct length. The zinc strips then travel through a progressively narrow channel and over a cylinder. This rounds the profile. More rollers improve on the U-shape and also curl the edges of the gutters to reinforce them. This gives the zinc rain gutters their final shape. The automated profiler ejects the 13-foot-long gutters onto a rounded rack. Then, it tips to stack the gutters neatly on top of each other. These zinc rain gutters are ready to hang. On site, they'll be welded together and attached to the roof with special hooks. They should come in handy on a rainy day. The French Basque Country is culturally quite distinct from the rest of France. Located in the southwest, bordering Spain, The region is known, among other things, for its ham, which is salted and air-cured in an old tradition passed down through generations of Basque farmers. There are several types of traditional Basque ham. This one, called quintoa, is marbled with fat and has a deep, strong, fruity flavor. Its distinct taste and composition begin with a specific breed of pig, the Basque country piebald, referring to the animal's skin. This pig breed is native to the Basque region, where livestock are raised on small farms in the valleys of the Pyrenees Mountains. Unlike commercially farmed animals, the female pigs have small litters of 6 to 9 piglets, which grow up roaming and grazing along the vast mountainsides on an average of 2 acres of land per 30 piglets. As a result of this free-range rearing, the pigs grow more slowly and become heavier than commercially farmed pigs. Once the animals reach a weight of about 330 pounds, which usually takes a year to 15 months, they go to the slaughterhouse. Each carcass is stamped with an identification number. Traditional ham is made from the hind legs. After tagging the leg, a worker places it in a machine which brands the quintoa symbol into the flesh. Then, another worker spreads dry salt on the exposed portion. The salt comes from Saïd de Bayarn, a saltwater spring in a basin bordered by the Pyrenees Mountains, the Adour River, and the Atlantic Ocean. Workers leave the salted ham in a cold, damp room for 1 day per every 2 pounds, typically about 15 days per ham. The salt preserves the meat. Next, the ham undergoes a first dry curing. It hangs on a stainless steel rack in a temperature and humidity controlled room for 7 months. When the ham comes out of the room, it has lost about 20% of its original weight because most of the moisture has evaporated. A worker brushes off the surface and coats the exposed part of the ham with a special grease that's made out of pig's kidneys, rice flour, and water. This grease prevents the surface from drying out and crusting during the second dry curing. The ham now goes into a second drying room, which dries the ham in the open air, taking advantage of this particular geographic location. A warm southern wind from Spain and humid air from the Atlantic Ocean to the west blow into the room through windows. Nature does all the work. Humans merely regulate the airflow and humidity by lifting or lowering the blinds. In this room, the ham hangs from a wooden rather than stainless steel rack. That's because the wood absorbs excess humidity and transfers moisture to the meat if the air gets too dry. As the ham dries, its flavor concentrates. The charcutier, an artisanal pork butcher, inspects every ham carefully. The wind that dries the ham carries pollen and other natural particles, which give this ham a distinct flavor and fragrance. The secret is slow curing until the ham reaches optimal maturity. That takes approximately 1 month per 2 pounds. So the ham remains in the second drying room for more than a year. When the cured ham is ready, workers sprinkle it with espalette pepper, a mildly hot pepper from the northern Basque country. This gives the ham a fragrance that's as appetizing as its taste.